Xin tự giới thiệu, em là Đặng Quỳnh Anh, học sinh lớp 8E trường Trung học cơ sở Sông Trí. Trước khi đến với cuộc thi Đại sứ Văn hóa đọc năm nay, em là một cô bé vô cùng yêu thích sách. Với em, sách là một người bạn lớn, là người thầy trên bước đường đến với tri thức. Hơn thế, mỗi câu chuyện em được đọc với những nhân vật, những mảnh đời khác nhau đã đem đến cho em bao cảm xúc, để em biết yêu, biết ghét, biết đồng cảm sẻ chia, nhất là với những cảnh đời éo le, bất hạnh của những trẻ em đáng thương trong cuộc sống. Trong số đó, câu chuyện cuộc chia tay của những con búp bê của tác giả Khánh Hoài thực sự đã ám ảnh em bởi tình cảnh đáng thương của hai anh em Thành và Thủy. Gia đình đổ vỡ, con cái không được đến trường, nhưng có lẽ đau đớn nhất là chúng phải xa nhau. Đó là cuộc chia tay đẫm nước mắt. Gấp trang sách lại, hình ảnh về cuộc chia tay ấy vẫn khiến em day dứt. Ước gì ba mẹ các em vì mái ấm gia đình, vì sự đoàn tụ của các con mà nhìn nhận lại, trở về bên nhau, để ngôi nhà lại ngập tràn tiếng cười của trẻ thơ. Bởi lẽ đó, đến với cuộc thi hôm nay, em đã viết tiếp phần kết cho câu chuyện, như một ước nguyện của riêng em dành cho Thành, cho Thủy và cho biết bao em nhỏ đang có hoàn cảnh đáng thương như thế.
The sun still shines brightly on the familiar road where I stood and looked at the truck picking my mom and my little sister up that day. My heart almost broke and everything around me was as frozen. Same old, same old. Whenever I see our two dolls, Vệ Sĩ and Em Nhỏ, on the headboard, my heart tightened and my sister's teary eyes appeared in my mind. Up to now, my sister's words has kept haunting me in my dreams every night. You must promise not to let them sit apart, remember?
That fateful day suddenly came to us like a tsunami, and then washed away all the peace that we should have had. The scenery is still the same. Some dahlia flowers in the garden that Thủy liked still show up their bright beauty in the morning sunlight. Life is as busy as usual, but the cozy scenery of the previous days will never return in our house anymore. The day my mother and my sister went away, left me alone on the empty street. I didn't know whether I could still cry or not, because my heart was suppressed and pinned by the feeling of disappointment and pain. 3 days later, my father came home. His face was visibly tired, emaciated, and alcohol smelled. I know he still loves my mother very much. Until now, I have never seen my father, a gentle, taciturn man, a person who always goes to work and comes back home regularly, has changed out to be like that. During that sole 3 days, I kept my two dolls with me all the time and wondered, when can I see you again, Thủy? 5 year time has passed. 5 years may be just short for many people, but with me, it passed tediously day by day. One day, my father told me, Thành, this year you are going to take a university exam. Try to pass it. His face was still apathetic. I realized, since the day my mother and Thủy left, our house has become gloomy without any laugh. Everything still happened drearily. I think I'm still luckier than my sister because I am able to go to school, unlike my sister. She had to quit school and sell flowers in the market. I have written to Mom and Thủy many times, but never once did I receive a reply. I knew that in the countryside, my younger sister would no longer be able to go to school, and my mom also had to undertake a lot of things. Thinking about that, my heart feels like it's worth being strangled painfully, where she stands on the headboard every night to protect my sleep, but I couldn't sleep any night. That dinner, my father once again told me, "You should eat well to have enough strength to study, remember?" As usual, I answered yes and continued eating. Then my father put down his chopstick, stood up and said, "Your mother and your sister are fine." Having heard that, a lot of happy emotions was mingling in my head. From that day, I started to make my own plans. I think my father will no longer stop me when I have an intention of leaving home and looking for my mother and sister. When the early shower starts, a little bright sunlight appears. Phoenix flowers blooms. Asian chorus start to sing. The summer comes. In the July hot days, parents forgot all the hardship to accompany and encourage their children in the days when they pass the university graduation exam. Although I don't have anyone by my side, I still walked alone on my own path. Everything happened as fast as the summer showers. The university graduation exam was over. I was about going home to meet my father and ask him for going to the countryside to visit Mom and Thuy. Thinking about that, I felt so happy that I ran back home quickly. When I got home, the house was still gloomy like the day my mother and Thuy left. A few moments later, I said, "For many years, the nostalgia for mother and my younger sister has not ceased. The university graduation exam is also over. I just ask you to allow me to finish my dream, that is to return to visit my mom and Thuy. Can I?" My dad dumbfounded for a moment. Then he looked at me, nodded slightly. The way to the countryside was very far, but no matter, in my heart still had an indescribable joy. But in contrast to my eager mood, when I arrived at my maternal home, I only saw my mother lying weakly on the bed. Her face paled, but it can't erase her gentle appearance. It turned out that my mother was seriously ill for weeks. Sitting next to her was a cute girl with round eyes. I choked, stuttered, and then suddenly sobbed, "Mom, Thuy." Then Dad came to sit by my mom's side and said, "I knew my mistake, my stubbornness of youth, the impatience in the decision has made each of us suffer too much. I know I'm wrong. I don't expect you to forgive me, but I hope you allow me to make up for you in the last day of your life. Can I?" Mom bursted into tears. "Hug Dad. I know she doesn't hate Dad at all, and she still can't forget the man of her life." Then I went out to the garden with Thuy. She remained silent since that. No one said anything. My little Thủy has grown up, but her round eyes are unmistakable. Suddenly, she cried and said, Dad has come here many times, do you know? He begged Mom and I to come to live with you after you finished the university graduation exam. He said that you wrote a lot of letters for Mom and me. Dad said, you will go to fight Mom and me. During the past few years, Dad came here and asked Mom to let me to go to school instead of selling flowers in the market. Dad asked Mom to let him raise us until we finished school. Dad told me about you, but he told me not to reply you so that you can have the will to study. Tears welling up, it turned out that my father had done everything silently. I didn't know anything. I ran into the house. Thủy followed. We hugged each other. A happy family, the people I've been longing for, was finally by my side. My wish has come true. From now on, Vê Sĩ and em nhỏ will no longer be lonely every night.